Good morning, dear students. This video is for class 10th, subject science, chapter 2, lecture 4, homework solutions by Sarika Kumari. So let us see what was the homework of lecture 4. So lecture 4, three questions were there in the homework. First question was, identify the acid radicals and basic radical in calcium sulfate. Second question was, calcium sulfate was prepared by the reaction of an acid and a base. Identify the acid and the base that must have been used in the reaction. The last question was, write three methods for the formation of salts, keeping chemical properties of acids and salts in mind. So let us see the solution for the first question. So here is the answer. Identify the acid radical and basic radical in calcium sulfate, which is a salt. So as we know that acid radicals are the ions coming from the acid part of the salt, and basic radicals are the ions which are coming from the base part of the salt. So acid radical will be sulfate, SO4, 2 negative, and basic radical will be Ca2 plus, that is calcium 2 positive. As calcium sulfate is obtained by the reaction of sulfuric acid and calcium hydroxide. So calcium hydroxide is the base. So the ion coming from calcium hydroxide is Ca2 plus, and sulfuric acid H2SO4 is the acid. So SO4 2 negative will be the acidic radical. Now next question is, calcium sulfate was prepared by the reaction of an acid and a base. Identify the acid and the base that must have been used in the reaction. So in the previous question also we have discussed that calcium sulfate is a salt and it is obtained by the reaction of a acid and a base, because calcium sulfate is a product of a neutralization reaction between acid and base. As sulfate is the acidic radical and calcium is the basic radical, so sulfate, it must be taken from sulfuric acid, and calcium is taken from calcium hydroxide, which is a base. Let us see the reaction. So we have identified the acid and the base that must have been used in the reaction. Next question is, write three methods for the formation of salts, keeping chemical properties of acids and salts. So although while discussing salts, one very common method of formation of salt, we know that neutralization reactions of acids and base. So the very first method of formation of salt is by neutralization of acid and base. When an acid and base reacts together, they forms a salt and water. So for example, we have sodium hydroxide reacting with hydrochloric acid gives sodium chloride, which is a salt, and water H2O. Second method, by the action of acids on metals. So whenever acid reacts with a metal, it produces a salt and hydrogen gases liberated. For example, zinc, when it reacts with sulfuric acid, it forms zinc sulfate and hydrogen gases evolved. Why this reaction is happening? Because of the standard electrode potential. Here zinc is having higher standard electrode potential than hydrogen, so it is replacing hydrogen from the acid, and then it is forming zinc sulfate and hydrogen gases. Hydrogen is replaced from the acid and hydrogen gases evolve. one more method for salt formation. The third method is by the action of acids on metal carbonate and hydrogen carbonates. So when metal carbonate or metal hydrogen carbonate reacts with an acid, it produces salt, water and carbon dioxide. For example, we are having calcium carbonate. When it reacts with hydrochloric acid, it forms calcium chloride, water and carbon dioxide. So calcium chloride is a salt here belonging to chloride family. So these were the solutions of chapter 4 homework. So third question was related to the chemical properties of acids and bases. Thank you and have a nice day.